Hey there, so you're playing the violin, maybe for a short while. You've successfully learned the first finger, second finger, third finger, all was going well, and then that nasty pinky, you just don't get it in its place, or you're struggling with your whole handhold suddenly. Now, this video will give you a solution if you have the feeling that your pinky is simply too short for playing the violin. Now, as you can see, for me also, my pinky is a lot smaller than the other fingers. You see, it's below this knuckle of my ring finger, you see? And then you might be thinking, yeah, Zlata, but you've got beautiful, slim, long fingers and it's perfect for playing violin. Well, that's a myth, because there are many great violinists, like for example, Oris Strach, who don't have a specifically long pinky and don't even have very slim or long fingers. There are many examples of top level players who don't have the hand that we think is suitable for the violin. So don't worry about that. Well, the main thing to focus on is the posture of your arm and your left hand and fingers. Now, a mistake that I see a lot of beginners make is that they put their violin too much to the left, or that they have this arm too much there and that it doesn't really turn enough to help your fingers reach the string, because your arm and your hand need to help your left hand fingers to be able to reach the string. Your pinky doesn't have to do it all alone. So first of all, make sure that this arm is relaxed, but also that it's hanging under the violin. You must have the feeling that you have a weight under your elbow, and maybe that you're just hanging on the violin like that. I don't mean that literally, it's just a feeling that you need to have, otherwise you are straining your neck too much. So really embrace your violin with the arm. I made a whole video on violin posture and hold. You can watch that right here, because that explains all about how to hold your violin, how to stand when you're playing violin. And what's important for your hand posture, if you got that arm position right, is you have to turn in your hand a little bit. You can't really avoid it. You don't have to have your knuckles completely, you know, like this, because in violin playing, you actually look at your fingernails. But you don't want to be like this. Also, mind your wrist. If you have your wrist there, you see, it's pulling away your fingers from the string. Can't reach the string with my pinky, even if you do it a little bit. So either have your wrist straight or a slightly giving handhold, with which I don't mean this, okay? Because a lot of beginners play like this, and then you're also pulling away your fingers. Then you see, then I can't reach the notes in that way. Can't reach them in that way. But you have to be there somewhere in between. And everybody is different. So you really have to find out your own ideal position for violin playing. Also, the violin hold can vary a little bit. The way you adjust your chin rest and whether you use a shoulder rest and how you adjust it, that differs per person. It's very personal. Then just experiment placing those four fingers. And what also helps is that you roll your hand a little bit in the direction of the fourth finger. You see, you don't have to place all the fingers. It gives you stability, of course, but if you just lift the first finger a little bit, then you've got more room for your fourth finger. Try to place it nice and curved and not like that, because that's really hard to make your intonation consistent, meaning it's very hard to play in tune in a reliable manner. So also practice the movement that your left hand makes, okay? Now, your ring finger and your pinky are connected in a way, so we must also train the finger independence. And I've got a wonderful Dunis exercise for that, that is in this finger independence video. I also have some etude books I recommend by Hans Siet, by Stradiek, and you can download them for free at imslp.org. But I'll also link to Amazon where you can buy these books, and then you have some really useful exercises to train that independence and that strength and that reliability of your fourth finger. Now, in my violin studio, if you really take the time to search for a good left hand technique and posture, it's possible for everyone to reach the fourth finger. But if you have specifically very short fingers or very short arm or both, then it can also make sense to try out a 7/8 size violin. And if you're thinking, yeah, I've got a beautiful violin and I don't want the kids fiddle, the 7 eighth violins are by all means an adult size. And there are beautiful antique violins that are that size. So it's definitely not something weird. There are professionals in orchestras playing with a 7/8 violin. And if you tried it out at a violin shop maybe, and you instantly feel a relief and you instantly have the idea that, oh wow, now it finally works, then maybe that's the solution for you. So really take the time to find good posture, but also, you know, accept it when you might need a different size violin. And a 7/8 is just a little bit more than a centimeter smaller than a full size violin, but it can make a lot of difference. But in general, it's practice and, you know, just clever searching for a good hold for you. So I hope this video is helpful. If you are a beginner and you're looking for a good curriculum, then really consider taking my free beginner course that I'll link to right here. It's a YouTube playlist and it also includes all the free books and sheet music. So I hope to see you in a next lesson. Make sure to subscribe and see you next time. Bye bye.